Growing up, I worked with my dad. My dad owns a thrift store that is based in Costa Rica, but also operates in California. I would help him with either loading the trucks, unloading the trucks, finding holes or stains on the clothes, and even learn how to use Excel in elementary school to help him. I mostly worked during elementary and middle school, occasionally during school, and mostly during summer, since I didn't have anyone to take care of me during this time, and I didn't need to go to summer school, so my dad thought it was best to take me to work with him. I learned a lot during that time. Once I got to high school, I had the choice. I honestly didn't really like going to the warehouse because I didn't have anyone my age to be there to talk to, and it just seemed boring to me. So once I got into high school, I had the choice. Obviously, I chose not to go to work. It wasn't mandatory. My dad wasn't struggling during this time, and he gave me the choice on focusing on school. And I chose that. I went to high school. I didn't need to work during this time, but once I graduated, I even chose to do esthetician schooling and got my license. That was what I was hoping for during my future. I didn't really have anything else planned but going to school or college and finding a career that I wanted to do. I never really thought about working for my dad too much. That wasn't really my dream that I wanted to do. It wasn't my passion. Once I got my license, it was during the pandemic and everything kind of felt like it was at a stall. I could not work. Since we work inside and we work very close to people, the pandemic basically shut down all estheticians. But my mom has suggested that I would ask my dad if he had any positions or even just he needed some help at the warehouse. I had moved out at 18 from this house and started to live with my mom, and I did not have too much contact with him. But I said, why not? I would probably mostly be helping with the clothes and organizing and with tracking the clothes, so I didn't really mind doing that. But when I asked him, he said, yes, I do need some help actually. He had moved to a bigger warehouse, and with the warehouse, there was a storefront. So he said that he wanted to make the storefront into a thrift store and said that I could help with him. I thanked him because I was really in a tough patch during this time, and I started working with him. Now it's been 6 months of me creating a thrift store. I created the logo, the design of the thrift store, down to the paint that I want to put up to it, and I am very excited. I had always grown up thinking of ways that I could like help with the store and creative ways too. And I didn't want to disappoint myself. This has been an exciting journey that hasn't come to an end yet, but I'm excited to see what I can accomplish.